Energy is really essential for the type of lifestyle we have. And when people say, we should just make 100% wind and solar, they have to be realistic and say, is there anyone in the world who can pay for that? And I think they completely miss the point there. They're not willing to go down and figure out what it's gonna take to actually do this. And with thorium energy, I think if you start to study it, you realize that it can actually be done. And when I first read about it on the internet, I thought, this is bollocks. This can't be true. So I'm Thomas Jam Pedersen. I'm one of the founders of Copenhagen Atomics. I read an article on the internet where it said a ball this size made out of thorium can supply all the energy I need for my entire life. Not only the electricity that I need, but also all the energy I need to produce all the products I need, all the energy I need for flying in airplanes, driving cars, producing those cars, producing all the products, the clothes and all the buildings and roads I need in my entire life. That's a lot of energy. It's a huge amount of energy. And all that energy could be delivered from this little ball of thorium. And I thought, that's amazing. I thought, it can't be true, but I'm an engineer, so I have to go home and calculate if it's true. It might be true, but I don't believe it. So I went home and I did the calculation, and it turned out it was not very difficult to calculate. And when I sat down and realized 15 minutes later, it is true. It was really a groundbreaking minute for me, because I realized this is not bollocks. This is really true. There's all this energy. And I knew already then that there's lots of thorium in the world. There's enough thorium to supply the entire humanity for thousands of years. It would cost around $100 for a ball this size. And that means that your entire energy you need for 1 year would cost less than $1. And that's amazing. And then my quest really started to find out, why are we not using this? And if we were going to use it, how could we use it in an efficient way? So we all know that we need to take care of this planet. We need to stop using fossil fuels. And some people say, okay, we can just use less energy. But even the people who say that won't use less. So, I mean, who's gonna start using less? Because energy is really what drives prosperity in our society. So who wants to say, yeah, I'm going down to half prosperity of what I have today? Nobody wants to do that. So what are we gonna do? We gotta find some other solutions. Fusion is one of them, but they are always saying 20 years from now. But they have done that for 50 years now. So it might happen, yeah, okay, let's hope for that. But in the meantime, all of us who doesn't work on fusion, let's work on something else. The world really needs a solution for energy. And if you have part of the solution, I think you are responsible for stepping forward and supplying your part. And then hopefully other people will do the same. You can use thorium in a number of different ways, but the only way I'm talking about here is if you use it in a configuration in a what we call a molten salt reactor, and sometimes it's also called a lifter. It's safe, it's low cost, no CO2, it's easy to make. Basically, you burn all the fuel, whereas in the old type of nuclear reactors, you only burn 1% of the fuel you put into them. So already there, you have 100 times better efficiency than in old type of nuclear reactors. At the same time, in old nuclear reactors, you have to have a lot of pressure, and that means that you have to build huge buildings, and that become really, really expensive. But with this lifter type reactor design, you can build it small, and you can build it on an assembly line, just like we build cars and airplanes. So the cost of building every power plant is vastly different. We are a small team, we're 10 people working on this. And if you wanted to build a car from scratch, you would need to build the brakes and make sure that works, okay? You need to build the gearbox and make sure that works. And that's what we're doing right now. We're building all these subcomponents and testing them to make sure they work and make sure that they're ready for when we get a real investment to build a real power plant. The next big step is to build a prototype reactor, like the first reactor, and we can turn it on and show people that it's working, it's producing energy. And that would take, I don't know, maybe 5 years. You know, in the long term, what I would really like to see is that we could make energy a non-issue for the global population of humanity.